What is up, y'all? Hope y'all having a great day. We're out here at Kingsmill at the River Course for part two in the back nine. Finished at 200 par on the front, so we've got the opportunity to take it low and shoot in the 60s. See if we can't start off strong here on the back. Par four, 419 yards, kind of bends a little to the right to get high, let it fly. Tee shot's gonna play pretty straight. However, the green sits off back to the right. There are some bunkers down the right and a bunker down the left. We're just gonna be aiming right down the middle. Down the right side, probably in the rough, but should be decent. Like I said right there, it was gonna be decent, right rough, and all of a sudden, it's like the wind kind of settled down. We were hitting that tee shot back there and the wind was whipping, and the whole front nine, the wind was whipping. So hopefully, this would be fun to play this back nine with not much wind. It'll probably pick up here in a second. 145 left, back right hole location. With no wind, I'm gonna go ahead and hit a pitching wedge. Caught a flyer right there. That one is a little long. A little work to do. That pitching wedge flew a long ways. Like I said, a little bit of a flyer. It's kind of like a little slope right there, just short of the flag. So land it maybe just a little right. Hopefully trundle right on down there close.
I was gonna break a little to my right. Oh, that's an unfortunate bogey here on 10.
Never like to start the back nine with a bogey. However, that's what we did. A bogey's in the past. We are at one under par on the day, one over par here on the back nine. Number 11, par four, 408. All righty, does bend to the left and the green sits off back behind that bunker right there.
Oh boy, that wind is strong. That wind picked up and I thought I could carry the corner of that bunker there. That did not even come close to carrying it.
So I didn't shoot the lip of the bunker and it just didn't look that far. I thought I would carry it pretty easily. And that carry of this bunker into the wind was never gonna happen. I'm right here, kind of down there in the middle. I've got 159 to a back left hole location. I've got to stop creating so much spin with my driver. They're kind of ballooning up and into the wind. Not ideal numbers. Those things just kind of balloon up in the wind and fall out of the sky. So thin to win, right? Yeah, definitely caught that a little thin out of that bunker. However, from that distance, they're not gonna go that much further. It actually ended up roughly pin high. Thankfully, there's like a slope right here to kind of stop it. Just chipping back down the hill, see if we can't get this up and down for par.
Here on 11.
Number 12, par 4, 396, and this looks like a perfect stinger hole. We're just gonna aim pretty much straight, hopefully hit a good stinger here. This hole does bend back to the left right there. You can see the flag back around the corner.
How far that trundle, but we hit that one decent.
All righty, good shape right here. 161 yards left. Pin is kind of in the front there. We're gonna go with an 8-iron. This is right back into the wind.
I think it's just short of the flag, but it's putting, and I don't think it's much short. That was a good swing.
We are walking up here, and that is what we were looking for. It wasn't much short. It landed in the shadows here, and the pin was in the sun, so I couldn't really tell where it landed. However, just right there, spun back a few inches, 15 feet left for bird.
Bummer.
One under par here on the day and one over par here on the back. We're on to number 13, par 3, 175. A little bit of a crosswind here. It should be off the right, so it's going to be pushing that little baby cut into a straight ball flight. So we're just going to aim right at the pin, 8-iron in hand.
Kind of glaring up there, so I couldn't quite see it down. It looked like it landed into the shadow, middle of the green, just right of the pin.
That is what we were looking for out of those last two 8-irons right there, basically pin high. Didn't quite drift as much to the left as I thought or had hoped to. It is windy. This is one of the windiest days that I've played golf in a little while, so it does kind of swirl when you get back in these trees. However, we'll take that shot all day long. Drop a like down below if you enjoy these course vlogs, and also comment where you'd like to see me next. Been doing a lot of traveling here as of late, and hope y'all are enjoying all this content.
Like I said on the last screen, we got to start hitting these birdie putts a little firmer. Oh, that's a par.
And we're on to number 14 right here, par 4, 374. Bunkering down the left. I do think we can carry it. We're going to be taking it right over the corner of those bunkers.
Push that one out to the right. I think it should be fine, but might be right rough.
Good place to miss it on this hole. Lots of room over here, and we just found that out. 82 yards, back right hole location. Lob wedge in hand. We need a precise number here if we want to knock this close, because you don't want to be long, or at least that's the way it appears up there.
Didn't have much spin on it. It landed about pin high and just trundled off the back. I don't think it's off the back by much though.
Oh boy, we did not have much room to work with. It landed right there. We'll fix that divot here in a second. And it rolled to right here. And yes, that was like 6 inches from trundling way on down there. Not in bad shape. 25 feet or so. We're gonna roll the rock since we're just off the green. Anytime I can putt it, you wanna putt it.
Tracking and a little short again with another putt today. We need to go work on our speed.
I'm always a huge proponent of putting it when you can putt it, even if it might bounce just a little bit, because a bad putt is going to beat a bad chip all day long. We're on to number 15, par 5, 508, into the wind. This is a gettable hole, but with the wind, might be playing a little ways. There's a bunker out there, kind of middle of the fairway. That's gonna be our aiming point. All righty, that bunker right there in the middle, play a little butter cut off of that, and then the green sits off back in there.
Just landed right at that bunker. I couldn't tell if it kicked into the fairway, but should be in good shape. So this wind just kind of shifted on me here once I got up to the ball. It's almost straight downwind. 215 yards left, 6-iron in hand. It's time to score. That one out a little right. It almost got up there but kicked down into that bunker.
All right, so walking up here, my ball actually landed pretty much pin high. It landed right here. We've got a little bit of green to work with right here. Hopefully land it right up in there, let it trundle on down, see if we can't get a pin slammer.
That was a huge momentum swing right there. Pin slammer here on 15.
Love to see that. First birdie here on the back moves us to 2 under par. 3 holes remain. We get a peek at the, I believe it's the river down there. I guess that's why they call it the river course. Behind the green back there, we're gonna get some cool views coming up. Number 16, par 4, 458. Tee it high, let it fly. Pretty much straight away, that tree right there is what we're gonna be aiming at. Looks like it bends down to the right.
We played a cut off of that tree. Didn't really see it down. I think it should be okay, but might be in the right rough.
We sure have loved these fairway bunkers here on the back nine at Kingsmill. And how about that view? The river course is showing some cool views. Love to see it. 155 left, slightly down the hill, 9-iron in hand. Much better swing out of the bunker right there. Right side, roughly 30, 35 feet, putting back down the hill. And this view right here, y'all, pretty incredible. Looks like number 17, a par 3 over here, runs right alongside the water. Can't wait for that. However, we're right here on 16. See if we can't roll this in. Would have loved to have made that birdie putt right there, especially with a rainbow behind. It's kind of starting to drizzle a little bit. This is a double rainbow. What in the world? That is amazing. This place has been so much fun, and we've got a little bit of history here. It is awesome to be standing right here. In 1607, the first English settlers hit land, like right here. I don't know, it could be here on this tee box, could be up on the green, I don't know. Somewhere up in here, the first English settlers, yes, made landfall. I'll hold it up here so you can read that if you would like to, but that is pretty awesome. Wow, also, there is a cannon here. I see the end of the rainbow, are you kidding me? Look at this. It is literally in the water. I don't know if I've ever seen the end of a rainbow. I mean, it's like right there. So after all of that, that was just a cool moment. Really enjoyed that. Hopefully you learned a little bit about history right there. That was cool. Number 17, par 3.
That is front edge. That wind kind of quartered, I guess. It was playing a lot longer than I thought.
Like I said, that ended up well short. Yes, we have a monstrous putt right here. I don't even know. This is like 65 feet. So yeah, if we make this, this would top the putt that I made in the front nine video. Also, walking up here, wanted to know what these trees are. Could somebody tell me down in the comments, if you know what this tree is, like what kind of tree is that? They look pretty cool. So with the water down to the right, I think I'm gonna play this a little left, and I'm sure the ball breaks to the water, so that's where we're gonna play it. and hopefully we just get good speed here.
That right there was not very good. That was a total misread. That is an unfortunate three putt. Never like to see those. However, we're on to 18.
And this is it. We are on the final hole of the river course here at Kingsmill. And hopefully we can finish strong with a birdie shooting the 60s. This is a par 71. So if we shoot two under, that would be 69. That would be so much fun. We're on to 18. Par four, 450 yards. We're gonna hit driver here. We're gonna be aiming at a little chimney out there off in the distance. Like I said, this hole bends around the water to the left. There's the green, and there's the chimney I was speaking of.
A lot of wind, back into the face. Tee it high, let it fly. And that was that spinning drive that I was talking about. Not hitting it real far. Catching it too spinny. That one ballooned on me. Little right. I think it's still in the fairway, but yeah, we got a long ways home.
That was another one of those kind of spinny drives that I was talking about earlier, that I'm hitting too hard down and to the left, which does not optimize your numbers with driver. We're right here, 175 left into the wind. I've got to go sort that out. Start swinging up and to the right. Launch it at a better launch angle with less spin when I'm hitting into the wind, because these numbers today, not ideal.
Oh boy, yeah, that's in the bunker. A little short right. We need to go get that up and down. Here on the last.
Huge up and down right there to finish out of the bunker. Finish at one under 70. This is a par 71, so finish at 70. Would have loved to have finished in the 60s. However, we'll get them next time. Hope you enjoyed coming along for this journey at the river course at Kingsmill. This place is awesome. Check it out. These finishing holes have some awesome views and some really cool history. And y'all, until next time, we'll see you when we see you. Peace.